Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam ma ba'd. Ayyuhal ahabbati fillah. Continuing on, we reach the fifth condition for la ilaha illallah, which is truthfulness, is sidq. And the fifth condition of truthfulness is what opposes sidq or truthfulness is hypocrisy and dishonesty, lying. This means that when we say the Shahada, we are saying it honestly and that we actually mean it. We're not lying when it comes to our testimony of faith. This is imperative, habita fillah, that we're truthful in Islam and we're truthful. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, in the Dalil from the son of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasalam with regards to this, he alayhi salatu wasalam said, no one bears testimony that there being no one worthy of worship except Allah, sincerely from his heart, there's this truthfulness. Except that Allah makes the hellfire forbidden for him. Ruahu Bukhari wa Muslim. In this hadith, habita fillah, the shahid is that the person has made the testimony of faith with sincerity in their heart, in his or her heart. And from the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَكُولُ آمِنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and of mankind are some who say, we believe in Allah and the last day. When they believe not, they think to deceive Allah and those who believe, and they only deceive themselves, but they perceive not. In their heart is a disease, and Allah increases their disease. A painful punishment is theirs because they lie. So the Shahada, it requires truthfulness, ahabati fillah. The sixth condition, ahabati fillah, is sincerity. The next one is sincerity, ikhlas lillah. And as we mentioned, what's implicit in the Shahada, or in Islam, is the Islam lillah bi tawheed wal inqiyad lahu bi ta'ati wa khulus min shirku ahli. All of that, what's implicit in that definition by the ulama, is a lot of the conditions for the Shahada. And sincerity is one of those. We have to be sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we are Muslims for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of our worship goes to Allah, who we've never seen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most merciful. We worship Him. We love Him. We want to be loved by Him. Ahabbati fillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitab al-kareem, fa'budillaha mukhlisin lahu deen. Worship Allah, make a religion pure for Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitab al-kareem, wama umiru illa liya'budullaha mukhlisin lahu deen hunafa'a wa yuqimu salah wa yutu zakah wa thalika deenul qayyimah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and they are ordained nothing else except that they worship, they serve Allah, keeping religion pure for Him as men by nature upright, and to establish worship and to pay the poor due. That is the true religion. وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. That's what the Shahada requires from us. That's what Islam requires from us. Sincerity and establishing the prayer and paying the zakat. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah has forbidden for the hellfire for anyone who says there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and say so desiring the face and pleasure of Allah. Ruahu Bukhari wa Muslim. Ahabati fillah, ikhlas, we can never speak enough about, and we've spoken many times in countless durus about the importance. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Inna ma'amalu bin niyat." Verily, actions are tied by the intentions. The Prophet ﷺ also said that about the first three people who will be punished on the day of judgment will be people who did deeds for other than Allah. One will be a person who was a mujahid, and the people thought he was a martyr, but in fact he did it for the praise of the people. The second one is a person who sought knowledge, and they were considered a scholar, and they were a person who memorized the Quran and taught the Quran, an alim. But in fact, they did it to get the praise of the people. So the people would say he's an alim. The people would say he's a talib al-ilm. The people would say he was this, or he was a sheikh, he was a muhaddith, whatever. The people the person sought their praise and they'll be thrown in the fire. And that's from a lack of ikhlas. And we ask Allah the Almighty to bless us with ilm al-nafi'a wa rizq al-tayba wa amal al-mutakabbilin wa ikhlas wa thabal ala sunnah wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.